I understand that creating consistent characters for children's storybook using AI can be a lot of hard work for some persons. So before now, you need to contact an illustrator to help you out with your children's book illustrations, which sometimes can be a bit pricey, especially if you are on a tight budget. But with the help of several AI tools in the marketplace, this has given everyone an opportunity to be creative. So the question is it possible to generate a consistent image in different variations? The answer is yes, at least 90% consistency if you would use my simple trick. And this is the same trick I used to generate consistent characters for my storytelling YouTube channel. But do not take my word for it. You will be the judge at the end of this video because I'm just about to blow your mind. And the best thing is, it is totally free to use. You ain't paying a dime. Plus, you will not need any Photoshop skills to bring the images to life. This can all be done using Leonardo AI. So let's assume you have your story already generated using ChatGPT or any AI software of your choice. So over here is a story ChatGPT generated using this prompt. It is all about a 5-year-old girl and a dog. They do go hiking together, skating, hunting, and all of those fun activities. But one day, it is said that the dog went hunting all by itself but never returned. And you know what, guys? I found the best technique for using ChatGPT to write a more reasonable and lengthy story with a personal guide, okay? So if you find it really hard to create a good story using AI, then let me know in the comment section. I will make a video about that. Now that you have your story generated, you would need to create a scene to bring the story to life, okay? So to start creating your characters, all you need to do is to head over to Leonardo AI. So here is Leonardo AI interface. And once you're on this page, all you need to do is to create an account if you don't have an account. But if you do have an account, now you click on the launch app, you'll be brought up to this interface to either sign up or log in. So I'm just going to log in because I already have an account. And once you do, you'll be brought up here. And right here, when you have 150, this is your daily token, okay? And all you need to do right now is just to scroll down and click on image generation. And this will lead you to an interface where you can start creating images. So these are numbers of images you can always generate at once. I love to keep it at 2 so that I don't exhaust my daily token. Now, the next thing you want to do is to work on your image dimension. I will leave the width and the height to be same thing. You can always mess around with the dimension. So this is our prompt. We're going to be using this prompt, and don't worry, I'll leave you with the prompt in the description box, okay? Now, the next thing you want to do is to change the fine-tune model to Leonardo Diffusion, okay? Leonardo Diffusion XL is one of the best models to use while creating children illustrations. So make sure your model is on Leonardo Diffusion if you are on the free version. So I'll click on the generate button and now scroll to see the generations. There you go. So we have the first image here. I think I really don't like this image. So one thing you want to do is, once the AI generates an image you don't like, there are two things you can always do. You can always change the prompt, or you click on the generate button to generate another similar image. So I'm gonna click on the generate button to have a similar image, okay? And there you go. So I think it's beginning to look better. Ensure you generate the best image because this will determine what your images will look like in the long run. So do not settle with an image you're not comfortable with, okay? So I'll go ahead and generate another. So you need to pay attention to all of the images you are generating. You need to look out for the body parts, if the fingers are complete, if the eyes are well positioned, the eyebrows, and all of this before you settle for an image, okay? So I'm taking my time to check out the best image for consistent character. So the more you click on the generate button to have a similar image, the better it gets. And if you agree with me, these images are beginning to look good. Now I think we'll have to settle with this image. So this image seems to be very perfect. As you can see, there are no errors, unlike the previous images we just generated. And if you look closely, this image seems to have a higher quality. So once you've gotten the image you want to use, and for us, this is the image we're going to settle for. All you need to do is to come over here where you have the three dots. You click on it. Now you click on copy seed, okay? Now paste the seed into your existing prompt, and there you have it. So to begin our image generation, I'm going to add to the prompt, and I'm going to say something like on a skating board. Then click on generate, and there you have it. As you can see, these images are same with the image in the multiple pools. So what the seed does is to tell the AI to generate the same image but in a different scene and pose. And if you look closely, these images are same. And I'm also going to go ahead and create a new image, but this time the subject here will be on a skating board, like a skateboard, and then with a puppy beside her. So these are the two subjects. Then click on generate to have it. And there you go. So if you look closely, it's the same girl, but this time with a dog on a skateboard. Exactly what we told the AI, or exactly what we have in the prompt. Pretty nice. Okay. So using AI to generate image is all about your creativity and your imagination. So this time I will change the subject to on a car. And same with the puppy. The puppy should be beside her. And let's see what it comes up with. Amazing, guys. I don't know about you, but this is the same girl from the very start. And if you look closely, the picture quality is superb, plus the colors. And the truth is, you probably would not have to upscale it, which is totally up to you. And don't worry, I'm going to show you a software to use, should in case you want to remove any unwanted objects in your images, okay? So now that you've learned how to create a consistent character, the next thing you want to do is to create different background or different scene for your images. And I've seen a lot of video tutorial here on YouTube telling you to generate a different background scene using a different software such as Canva, Microsoft Paint, and then you bringing everything down to Photoshop to merge it together. That can be a lot of hard work, okay? So in a second, I'm going to show you exactly how to change your background with just a prompt. So here is exactly what I would do if I went out on a pathway. So I'm just going to say something like walking along a pathway, and that's it. Then click on the generate button and wait for it. And there you go, guys. We have our image here. As you can see, this is a pathway, same girl. And this is the other image. I think I love this. This is actually very beautiful, guys. So this is how to change your background. This is how to have a new scene for your book or for your YouTube channel, should in case you're telling kids' story, this would actually fit. So far, these are the images we have generated. And if you want to be sincere, I think Leonardo AI did a very good job. The images are simple, and this is the same girl. And the best part of this generation is it comes with same team. The only faults here, and for me, which is not an issue, it's just a shoe. Sometimes a shoe comes in blue and pink, but I think that can still fly. So once you're done generating your image and you're satisfied with what you have, now it's time to download. You come over here and you click on this feature to download it. And this other feature here, what it does is to change the image into a video, which is really nice. You can try that out yourself. And over here is to upscale the image, but it's for a paid version. And this is to edit the image right here on Leonardo. And over here is the image guidance. If you want to generate a lookalike of the same image, then you can use this feature. So feel free and play around with the prompt. I just showed you exactly what you need to change here, okay? Just change the subject and you will be good to go. So I think I want to have a new background, like a new scene. And this time I will change it to something like surrounded with eels. And there you go, guys. Amazing. I'm so satisfied with these generations. As you can see, it is actually surrounded with eels, okay? So you'll be the judge. And let me know in the comment section if the images truly look alike. And if you have any other software that you use to generate consistent character, please do let us know. This would definitely help the community, okay? So all of these images I'm generating will be used for my children's storybook, okay? But there is a bigger picture here. You can actually use these images, you compile them together and make it into a video where you publish on TikTok and you get paid for doing that. And you can also publish it here on YouTube and you also get paid for that. So using my trick will help you create a more consistent character plus amazing backgrounds, okay? And this will be our last prompt and it is magical land. You generate, and there you go, guys. This is so beautiful and mind-blowing, being that you only need a single prompt to get this done. So I just showed you guys how I get to create my own consistent character. And if you find it super helpful, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're not a subscriber, please subscribe to the channel to keep it growing. On my next video, I'm going to show you exactly how to use Leonardo AI to make animated characters all for free. So you want to stay glued to the channel so that you don't miss out on any part, okay? And if for any reason you want to upscale your image, which I don't think there is a need, all you need to do is to come to this website if you're not using the paid version for Leonardo. So come to this website here. This website will help you remove every unwanted object and also the background plus upscaling the images, which is quite effective. So thank you very much and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.